All right, students, today we are going to discuss the complete web page. As I told you in the yesterday's lecture, that I'm going to create one full web page, right? And as an example, I'm going to discuss with you people the sample paper of 2016 and 17, right? And I'll show you the web page. This one is the web page that we have to create today, right? And we'll be writing the coding in text editor, that is the Notepad, right? And we have to follow these instructions. Is the paper visible to everybody? Everybody can view this web page, and these are the instructions. The instructions are: link color is black, background color is yellow, and visited link color is green. Now this background color is yellow means the background color of the complete web page, right? Then title of the page is Wildlife in India. Heading of the page is maroon. This is the heading. Image used is elephant.png, right? The image that has been used is elephant.png. Caption of the table is blue. This is the caption: threats to elephants. The color of the caption I told you is the short descriptive title given to the table. And this caption is blue in color. Table border is blue and size is 2. This is the size of the border. This is the size of the border and this is the color of the border. Am I clear up till here, students? Now, next, see this line. The links, the four links are 1.html, 2.html, 3.html, 4.html. In a very simple line, the examiner has given you the indication for the hyperlinks. Now, what this line means? You have these underlined words. These underlined words will act as your hyperlink. The first hyperlink, Sri Lankan elephant, it is connected with 1.html. Sumatran elephant, this hyperlink is connected with 2.html. Borneo elephant is linked with 3.html, and last, African elephant is linked with 4.html. I hope the symmetry is getting into your mind. Then the last instruction, the email ID for contact us is abc@xyz. See, this is again a hyperlink. But this hyperlink, the examiner is giving the instruction that this is linked with the mail. So this is with respect to mail to. When you will click on this hyperlink contact us, you will get connected with this email ID. This is the ID of the receiver. Right? Now, when you are going to create the coding for the web page, if any instruction is not given, now in this question, the examiner has not mentioned anything about font face, font color, right, and size of the font. Examiner ne aapko bilkul ye nahi bataya aapne kaun sa font lena hai, font ka size kya hona chahiye, heading h1 mein hai ki kisme hai. So what you are going to do in this case, you can take imaginary figures from your side. Make one thing very sure in your mind: heading preferably is in h1. Always prefer to mention the heading in H1 unless and until the instructions are given. Suppose instruction is given, heading is in H2, then you will particularly use H2. But if the question is silent about the size of the heading, always prefer to use H1, because the highest heading element H1 is basically for headings. Have I made myself clear to everybody? Then little bit instructions you can take from your own, like font color, font size, that you can take from your own side also, if they are not given. Then if they are given, well and good. But last point, don't change the complete scenario of the question. Don't change the complete scenario of the question. You are to cover all these instructions. These instructions are must. They must be covered in your coding. Right? Now, I'm going to start this coding. And already I have downloaded this image from Google. Right? Though image might not be exact image, but it is quite similar. So let me start the coding now. Is the notepad window and board paper both visible? Is notepad window and web page both are visible? Okay. Now let us start. All right, let us see the first instruction. Link color is black, background color is yellow, and visited link color is green. Title of the page is Wildlife in India. Let us start now. My first tag, HTML. Second tag, head tag. And inside the head tag, I'm going to use the title tag Wild Life in India. Whatever I'm writing in the notepad, is it visible to everybody, bete? Fine. Now, one point I want to tell you people here, this mistake was done in December pre-boards. Don't put double quotes here. In the question, double quotes are mentioned. See. But don't write double quotes here. It is to be avoided. Right? And head tag is to be closed over here. Now let us start the body tag and let us see what instructions are being given with respect to the body of the web page. First, link color is black. Link equal to black. Then next, background color is yellow. Background color means BG color is yellow. Don't write background color. You are to write BG color. The full form of BG color is background color. Then third instruction, visited link color is green. V link is green. Am I clear up till here? We have covered two instructions. Am I clear up till here? 10th class. All right. So up till here, 10th class, first two instructions we have covered. Right? Now let us see further. Third instruction, heading of the page is maroon. Now this is the heading, Indian elephant. First of all, it is in the center. It is in capital. Heading is mostly in capital letters. And heading is always in center. But the style, the size has not been mentioned. So I am going to take preferably H1. And no need to take center tag separately because heading element has one attribute that is called align. The attribute of all heading elements H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6, it is one attribute that is align. And align can take left, right, center value, right? So no need to take center tag separately, or if you want to take, you can take, right? But I am going to take align attribute inside the heading element. Now I'm writing the head. Second instruction he has given, color is maroon. So I am giving font color is maroon, right? Now my heading, Indian elephant. When you are writing the coding on the answer sheet, please make sure with respect to formatting also, don't write all the tags in one line only. You can give attributes here. You can write heading in the next line so that while checking, the checker has clear view of each and every aspect of the coding. Now here I'm closing the font tag and I'm closing the heading element tag. Right? Then image use is elephant.png. Now image, you can see image in the web page is aligned in the right side. Image is aligned in the right side and text starts from here. Text starts from here and image is aligned in the right. Right? So first of all, you have to set the image. So to set the image, what I am going to do, I'm going to use image tag image src equal to. Now from the point of view of examination, you people have been just provided with the name elephant.jpg. See here. But examiner has not told you it is in which folder, it is in which drive. So from examination point of view, you just write the name elephant.png. Am I clear? 10th, am I clear? Because the path, the URL has not been given to you. Straight the name has been given. Right? So you write it as it is. Don't write the absolute URL. In meritorious assignment, I gave one question, types of URL. Beta, there are two types of URL. Absolute URL, relative URL. Absolute URL means the complete URL. Protocol name is mentioned, server name is mentioned, location of the file is mentioned. Relative URL means just the path of the file. Right? But since I'm doing this question on laptop, I'm doing it practically. So I'm going to take the complete URL. Right? And let me have the picture over here. I'm going in the pictures, in the saved pictures. This is my picture which I have downloaded from internet. And right click on the picture, see the properties, copy paste the location. Are you able to view whatever I'm doing? Now, see the name of the picture, elephant. Extension is JPG. right? So I am right click on it, copy, coming to the notepad window, paste here. But the location is saved pictures. After this, put a slash, write the name of the image that with which you have saved and extension. My image is of JPEG. In the question, it is PNG. Clear? So I am shutting down this window. And now align equal to right. Because my image is on the right side, my image given is on the right side. So I have used align equal to right. Clear? Here one point I want to tell you. Don't do mistake in that point. First of all, you have to set the image, then you have to write this paragraph. Don't start writing paragraph first and then insert the image. If you will do so, what will happen? Image will come down. Paragraph will come up, image will go down. But as per the given formatting in the web page, see carefully. The image has been aligned right with respect to the text. Right? So you have to do the setting accordingly. And this setting will be possible only and only if you will set the image first. Right? Now, see the image carefully. It is getting a bit lengthy. It is going downwards. इसकी विड्थ थोड़ी बड़ी है तो व्हाट यू पीपल विल डू फ्रॉम योर ओन साइड यू विल यूज विड्थ एट्रीब्यूट इन द क्वेश्चन इट इज नॉट मेंशनड इट इज जस्ट टोल्ड इमेज यूज्ड इज दिस बट द क्वेश्चन इज साइलेंट अबाउट हाइट एंड विड्थ सो यू कैन सेट द विड्थ ऑफ द इमेज फ्रॉम योर ओन साइड आई एम टेकिंग 250 You can give width in the range 200 to 250, depending upon the format given. Right? Am I clear up till here totally? Students, am I clear up till here? All right. Now, I'm starting with the paragraph. The paragraph is, The Indian elephant alphas maximum this. Okay. So I am giving here P tag. I am giving here paragraph tag. But the question is again silent about the size of the text. Heading size is H1. Okay, done. But what is the size of paragraph? The question is silent. So from my own side, I am taking H3. Little bit smaller than the heading. Not much, little bit smaller than the heading. So I start writing the paragraph. The paragraph is the Indian elephant. Now in December exams, few students, what they did? Just to pass their time, they write the paragraph like this. And simply the last word. You will get zero for this. No marks will be given. Instead, the marks will be deducted. You are to write the complete paragraph. The Indian elephant, Elephas. Maximus Indicus is one of the three recognized subspecies. Is one of the three recognized subspecies of the Asian elephant. Are you able to see whatever I am typing, beta? Okay. And native to the mainland Asia. And native to the mainland Asia. Since 1986, Elephas. Since 1986, Elephas. Now see here. What I'm going to do. Beta, after the Elephas, you can see in the web page, the next line is going here. In the first line, after Elephas, we are going down. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to add here BR. Here I'm going to add BR. Right? Have I made myself clear what I have done? Students, have I made myself clear, beta, what I have done? Okay. Next, Maximus has been listed. Maximus has been listed as endangered. Endangered by IUCN. As the population has declined, by at least 50% over the last three generations. Estimated to be Now, after 60 to 75 years, the next line starts from here. So I put here BR. The next line is Asian elephants are threatened by. Habitat loss, degradation, and fragmentation. Up till here, if I am clear, please raise your thumb. Be fast in giving the response to me, 10th class. So that I am aware that you people are understanding what I am typing on the screen. All right. So moving further, now here I am going to add one BR because there is a gap here. After gap, C also. So I am going to add one BR, then C also colon next. Now here the link start. Here the, again you can see some space is there. See here, space is there. So I add one more BR after C also. Now, in the question, you can see hyperlinks with list. And which list has been used? An order list. And the bullet uses disk. So I'm going to add UL type equal to disk, right? My first list item, Sri Lankan elephant. Let us read the instructions given down. The four links are 1.html, 2.html, 3.html, 4.html. So first hyperlink, Srilankan elephant is linked with web page 1.html. So what is the command for this? LIAHREF equal to 1.html Sri Lankan elephant anchor tag closes and I close the list item. Beta, list item is considered to be an empty tag. You may avoid it. You can avoid it. Right? Second, list item AHREF equal to 2.html. Then next hyperlink is Sumatran elephant. So I'm writing here the hyperlink Sumatran elephant. And I close the anchor tag. Third is AHREF equal to 3.html. And let us see the next link, Borneo elephant. Borneo elephant. Right? And next command is AHREF equal to 4.html. And the last one is African elephant. Now finally I close my UL. Am I clear up till here? Am I clear up till here, class? All right, let's move further. Now we come to the table part. Table is in the center. Table is in the center. So I am going to use, first of all, br over here. Then I'm taking center tag, right? Now start the coding of table. Let us see the instructions given with respect to the table. Table border is blue and size is 2. So table border is equal to 2. Border color is blue. Right? Next. Caption of the table is blue. What is the caption? Threats to elephant. And it is blue in color. Now see how to write caption in colorful way. Caption tag. After this, take the font tag, blue, write the caption over here. Close the font tag and close the caption tag, right? Then start making the table. There is no row span call span feature, right? So we are going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, two cells in each row. So what I'm going to do is tr td1 td illegal hunting. And close the tr. And the alignment is in left side. So by default, data is always in left. So no need to take align attribute. Second is industrialization. I quickly copy paste it. Number two is industrialization. And number three is habitat loss. Right? Number four is fragmentation. And last is disease. Number five is disease. Clear? Am I clear up till here? All right. Now, then bottom message. For further inquiries and reservations, contact us. So here I close the table tag. And the next message is for further inquiries and reservations. For further inquiries and reservations, contact us. Contact us is again hyperlink, and the email ID has been given here. The email ID for contact us is abc@xyz. So let us use the mail to here. ahref=mail2:abc@xyz.com, and hyperlink is contact us. Right? Now here I close the center tag. Here I close my H2 tag. Here I close the body tag. And finally I close the HTML tag. Right? Now let us save this. Board sample paper 2016.html. Let us see how the page is visible in the browser view. See here. The image is not appearing. Let us see what is the problem in the image. Yeah, you can see the page. You can see the complete web page. Some setting is to be done again. Clear? Am I clear with the coding? Don't change the complete scenario of the question. Right? Don't change the complete scenario of the question. Little bit changes you can do. As you have seen in the coding, I have taken H3. So I have to close H3 here. Right? Little bit changes you can do. Because in the given question, you have noticed font face, font color, font size was not mentioned. So as per my coding, I have taken a heading in H1, rest of the text in H3, and I have enclosed the data in the paragraph tag. Clear? Am I clear? Now here, see here, you can see this area. Don't think it is call span. What they have done, they have increased the width of the table. It is not call span. They have increased the width of the table. So we can write the width over here. This is my table tag. I can add the width here. I'm giving the width 100. Let us increase more. See, have I made my point clear? And there is a gap here, so we can add one BR here after the table closing table tag. When you will finish your coding in the answer sheet, do give the revision. Don't just sit as it is. Do give a revision to all the commands that you have taken in the coding. Right?